Welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm glad you stopped by or stopped surfing through the channels and joined me. I'm Joanna Ward. You're on the move with me, yours truly, right here from Norcross, Georgia. Today, we're going to do what you guys have requested. We're going to continue showing you exercises you can do right from your chair. And that's just about anywhere, whether you're at work, whether you're in your lawn, whether you are even at church. By the way, we've decided to bring the pastors out of the pulpit and bring them to On the Move with Joanna Ward. And we have one of the most outstanding and fast-growing churches in Atlanta, the Favor Church. We have the Reverend Dr. Pastor Barry with us today. He's actually going to work out with me. Come on up, Pastor Barry. Yay! Give me five. You said, I'm not never scared. God ain't give me a spirit of fear.
That's right.
How you doing?
Doing well. Thank you so much for joining me.
Most people are scared.
Well, I'll tell you what, I am a little nervous. Listen, I see the muscles, I see the energy, but hopefully I'll be able to hang today.
I think you're going to do just fine. You said you're people from Bowman, South Carolina,
that's
right?
That's right, that's right.
It's some real people in South Carolina.
Right, they
are. We're going to start off. Everything's going to be simple. You don't know, so you guys know he doesn't know anything, but I'm going to show you. You don't have to be intimidated. Nervousness is okay. Fear is not. And so we're going to get started with a warm-up.
Okay.
By Ty Trebbit's next new song, New.
Okay, sounds great.
Okay, we're going to face the cameras, and we're going to start here.
New.
Yeah, just take your arms up. Take your arms up. Just like this.
Okay.
And that's one at a time. You guys joining Pastor Perry?
New. Everything new.
New. Breathe. Breathe. Three. Two. Last single, double. Two. Two to the right. There you go. And pump that arm up and down.
Okay.
Take a switch.
I'm ready to flow.
And there you go. I knew you looked like you had some moves on the move. Good job. There you go. Two. And two. Two this way. Two. Good job. We're going to do four more sets. Here's number three. Two. Last doubles. We're going to do singles now. Singles. Singles. There you go. Way to follow. Breathe. You got it. I know you're moving in that chair. Four more. We're going to take both arms up.
Okay.
Two. Last single. Take them up. There you go. Everything new. Behold, I'll do a new thing. Will you not know it? Come on. Side to side on those legs, y'all. Good job. Way to work them. There you go. Eight. Seven. We're moving. Six. Way to go. Five. Four. Three more. Two. Last single, double to the left. Two. There you go. Uh-huh. Way to work. Keep those arms up. That's raising up that blood flow. That heart rate. Eight more. Seven. Six. Five, good job. Four. Three. Two. Last doubles, side to side. Drop the arms, this feet. I think he's doing good. What y'all think? And we're gonna slide down.
Okay.
How you feel?
Good.
Good job, good job, good job. Four more. We're gonna do what are called hamstring curls.
Okay.
Four, three, two. Watch me. Curl right, left. There you go. Ready for new. Come on. And we're gonna count these out and do knee lifts. Four, three, two. Last single. Take it up here. Knee, 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 knee. Knee. Good job. Four to march. Three. Two. One. We're going to march it out.
Okay.
That wasn't that bad, right? We're going to take the shoulder stretch back.
Okay.
And forward. Good job. I think Pastor did a perfect job. I know you guys are like, yeah, he got on there. That's cool, pretty cool. So what we're going to do now is we're going to grab our chairs.
Okay.
We're going to move those up.
All right.
And we're gonna start off behind the chairs. I think we're good. I gotta dry my face off. Pastor Barry had me out here working hard. So Pastor Barry, what we're gonna do is we're gonna lean onto that chair.
Okay.
Remember, he doesn't know, you don't know, unless you've been watching my show. So we're gonna start off right, left, right here. There you go. And so what we're doing is we're getting that sculpting and toning right here through the arms. keeping a real light on our knees and legs. So if you have knee problems, don't be intimidated by this because it's a supported exercise. We're gonna do five more. We're gonna add our arms and our legs. Right. You can stay where you are until you get what I'm doing, okay? So you guys just do the best you can and follow me if you feel like it, okay? So as the right goes out, left goes up. This is mind body movement, right, left. Okay? Let's see what you got. You got it? Oh.
Right? I got
just
it.
Too much, yeah.
I got
just
it.
Keep moving until you get it.
Got it.
Breathe, breathe, breathe. Holy name. Eight more. Seven, six, five the doubles. Four, three, way to go. Two,
okay.
Last one, double. Switch sides, double. Switch it.
There we go.
Yeah, I see you working. You're doing a good job.
Right.
Twice, switch sides. Oh, my soul. Oh. Holy name. Four more. Three to singles. Two. Last doubles. We're gonna do it just one time here. Yeah. Come on. Use that chair to support yourself. How you doing, Pastor?
Doing good.
Awesome sauce. Eight. Seven to march. Six. Five. Four. Three, two, and one. Good job. We're going to march out. How's that? Give me a fist bump.
You're starting to pick up.
Okay. Well, we're in the workout phase now.
All right.
You're still doing good. And we're going to march ourselves right around to the front of that chair. We're going to bring your chair back here with mine. How you guys at home doing? If you're sweating like me, that means you've been working out. So we know that this is an issue. Yeah. That everybody wants. It seems like everybody wants to focus on the abs, but not the food or doing the work in the abs. So what we're gonna do is Pastor Barry and I, we're gonna just come here and do nice little crunches like so.
Okay.
Let me see what you got.
Okay.
There you go, that's cool. Just really light, because remember, some of something is better than none of nothing. So as long as you're doing intentional movements into fatigue, you're gonna see some results in your sleep, in your rest, in your balance, in everything that you do, I'm telling you. If you go for benefits first and a six-pack last, the six-pack will follow.
Okay.
Let's do eight more.
All right.
You're doing good. Five more.
Okay.
Three more. Two. And one. How's that?
I gotta give him a cornice.
No, you the only job was to get those feet and hands up, and I think you did that, okay?
All right.
Don't even think you didn't do it right. You did it right.
Right.
So we're gonna start here. All we're gonna do is a bicep curl, as if you're on your couch at home.
Sure.
We're gonna keep our legs out like this.
Okay.
And we're gonna do what's called pump and pedal. And it looks like this, and you can just join me whenever you get it.
Okay.
It's almost like we're running with weights. Now, if your arms get too tired because you have weights, all you have to do is put them down and still just keep it moving. Good job. So if you ever want to run and you believe in the benefits of running, trust me, this is ab, arms, and legs, and cardio right here.
It is.
And you never mess, you never left your chair, right?
Right.
Breathe. In through your nose and out through your mouth.
All right.
Good job, Pastor. You're doing a great job. Four more here. Three, we're gonna catch our breath. Two, and last one, we're gonna catch our breath.
Okay.
You good?
Good.
Awesome, Sauce. You're doing a wonderful job, by the way. And so we're gonna come here, we're gonna squeeze and lift.
Okay.
Squeeze and lift. Don't go all the way up, just squeeze. Slightly off here. So when you're wide, like so, you keep your legs wide.
Okay.
Just lift slightly.
Lift up, okay.
Not
up,
yeah, and then back together.
Back together.
Again.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, perfect. Good job. Oh, my soul. Oh, my soul. Good job. Lean in. Three more. Two. And one. Good job.
All right.
Didn't think something like that could work, did
right.
it? So now we're going to work that midsection by just going side to side. Just like this. This is our last one, and then we're going to cool down.
Okay.
Okay? Good job. Way to move. So again, we're doing all this seated because I want you to move. This is my whole goal, is to let you start respecting and appreciating the ability to move. No one appreciates movement more than someone who can't.
Sure.
Four more. Three, two, and one. And now we're gonna go to cool down. Thank you guys so much. You did good.
All right.
We're gonna cool down a little bit. I'm gonna take a deep breath here. In through your nose, out through your mouth. We're gonna relax in the shoulders here. Just let them hang, the hands hang. Again, one more time. And we're gonna take both arms out here. We're gonna flex back and forward. Inhale, the way. And we're gonna rotate, because you guys use those computers and phones so much. You gotta work those forearms. We're gonna reverse those circles. And we're gonna take it here. God is good.
And may your whole life.
Good job, everybody. Especially Pastor Barry. We're gonna take our chin to the shoulder here. Good job. And we're gonna switch. Stretch out here. Chin up. Always lift your eyes to the hills from which cometh your help. Your help is coming from anywhere else. I know you think it is. It's coming from the Lord. And let's take it over.
The way they should, your whole days.
And we're gonna take it back.
God is
in right. And we're gonna take it up here and switch. And we got one more stretch. Now, if this bothers your knees, that's fine. We're gonna come here. If you can come here, that's great. But if you come up here, that's even better. We're gonna lean forward and stretch that out.
Okay.
You can just pull it. You can just pull it here. This is cool. Like wherever. Yeah, that's perfect. Yeah. See, that's okay. A stretch. You feel a stretch?
I feel it.
Excellent. So you can do it like Pastor Barry. That is awesome. You want to take steps. This is all about progress, not perfection. Okay. And I know our human nature is like, I want to get it right the first time. I want to do it like you. But do it like you until you can do it the best that you can do. Awesome. Good job. Thank you guys so much for joining me. Pastor Barry is going to bring a word for us after we go and change and kind of clean up. He has a special word for you. But until then, I want you to understand that you can bathe yourself, your suffering, your pain, your past, people being pretentious. You can bathe everything in the blood of Jesus. I know that sounds like a foreign language to you, but it's a spiritual thing. That's why the spirit is in the blood. That's why Cain's blood cried out from the earth, because it still speaks. And so Jesus' blood still speaks on your behalf. I know it sounds like, Joanna, what do you mean? I'm suffering, I'm sick, I don't feel good. Even if nothing in your physical life changes, understand that God, through the power in the name and the blood of Jesus Christ, through the power of His Holy Spirit, He can transform your mind and your heart, which sickness, death, and all these other things cannot touch. There are some hidden parts of who you are.
Yes.
That nothing in this society, poverty, need, lack, want, hatred, cannot affect. Tap into that, and I promise you, every day going forward is gonna be better than today. We're gonna go clean up, get our lives together here, because we can't talk to you guys about what He's gonna bring from the Lord until we get all this sweat off of us, right, Pastor?
Sounds good.
So we're gonna go ahead and change. You guys grab some water, grab a pencil and paper so you can find out how to keep in touch with Pastor Barry. And thank you again for joining me in that workout. If you did one little thing, you're amazing. I'll see you in a minute. Thank you so much for coming back, allowing us to clean up. We have the pastor of the Favor Church, Pastor Barry. Thank you for cleaning up. You look great. Is this what we should expect to see on Sundays?
Well, I tell you what, it depends on what Sunday it is. I wore my Falcons jersey last Sunday.
Oh, did you?
I did.
Okay, so it's you have themes.
I do, themes, and then depending on how I feel that day.
Depending on how you feel that day,
that's
just
right.
Get up and do what God tells you to do.
That's right, and who I'm trying to reach that
until
day.
Until you're trying to reach, okay.
That's right.
Okay, so it is flexible. The pulpit isn't rigid.
Very much, yes.
You know, you got to preach in a suit every Sunday.
That's right. In fact, one of my biggest philosophies is not doing church as usual, but doing church unusual.
Unusual.
That's
okay.
Right.
Okay. Well, awesome. Well, look, first of all, you did a great job exercising on yesterday's
Thank you.
Show earlier. And so you definitely passed the test for that.
Thank you.
For the fitness part. And now we want to talk a little bit about the faith part.
Sure.
And I've been promising them that you have a word from them. And so we and
they and me. We want to hear a word.
Excellent.
What's
excellent.
Your word?
Well, excellent. Well, one of the things I want to say to you, you are doing a phenomenal job. In fact, I am inspired to get active and to get moving a little bit more. Thank you
awesome.
For showing me that right in the comforts of my office, I can get a whole lot done. So the next time you see me, I'm going to be slimmer and trimmer, I promise.
Good deal. Good deal.
Excellent. Well, one of the things that was really on my mind as we were working out and just thinking about the news, as most of us, when you turn on the news, a lot of times you see the worst things that have happened that day. And if you're on, if we're all honest, there's a lot of trouble that we see around us. I think about just some recent events. So 9/11, as we pause to remember the lives that were lost during 9/11. There was a memorial for the four young ladies who were bombed in Birmingham. Mm-hmm. We saw the fires in Hawaii.
Yeah.
In addition to that, we've also seen the hurricane in Florida, and then even the earthquake in Morocco. Mm-hmm. And so one of the questions I wrestle with is, what do we do in troubled times? What do you do in troubled times? And so, like most of us, we hear a lot of 12 steps to success, or, you know, three steps to being amazing, but we don't necessarily prepare people for what do you do when the tough times come? And so there's a passage that actually came to mind in John 11. It's the story of Mary, Martha, and Lazarus, when Lazarus dies. And most of us know that familiar scripture where it says Jesus wept, the short, arguably one of the shortest verses in the Bible. But the question I really wrestle with is, what do you do when trouble knocks on your door? What do you do when tough times come your way? And so one of the things that I want to encourage people today is to not get bent out of shape when trouble shows up. It's part of life. It's part of the territory. But the good news is that we know that God is ultimately in control. And so I think there are five quick things that I saw that I believe can help us all. Mm-hmm. One is when things are tough, tell Jesus. Mm-hmm. And so Mary and Martha, they run and grab Jesus. Hey, listen, Jesus, our brother's dead. And so a lot of times we tell everybody else, mm-hmm. but God, mm-hmm. but Jesus. So I want to encourage those who are listening, listen, tell Jesus, talk to Jesus. Mm-hmm. In addition to that, they were very transparent. In fact, some might say they were rude. Some might even say they had boldness. But they're like, listen, Jesus, if you would have been here sooner, our brother would still be alive. Mm-hmm. But I love their transparency and their right. authenticity. And again, as we were working out, it made me think about how it's important for us to get certain things out of our bodies, out of our being. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people are suffering because they're not transparent, authentic about their pain, their frustration, their anger, and they were mad at mm-hmm. Jesus. And so somebody today needs that spiritual license to know, listen, it's okay. Let God know you're upset. Mm-hmm. You wish things turned out differently. But then I love the fact that they turned it over to him. Mm-hmm. They said, listen, we're turning it over to you. Jesus, you're the only person who can reverse the situation. They turn it over to him. They trust him. And then ultimately, he calls out at the tomb, Lazarus, come forth. Lazarus arises. And so they had a testimony mm-hmm. to say, listen, things started out bad, but now this is how things turned out for me. So I just want to encourage somebody to say that whatever you're going through, it's not final. Mm-hmm. Just trust God. He can work it out for you.
That is an awesome, awesome, awesome message, because that is definitely necessary, especially with the culture and the climate that we have of, you know, people just being really, really temperamental about what really is life, as you said earlier. So what would you say to the person who isn't ready to receive
sure.
trauma, because we live in a positive vibes only,
right.
manifest whatever you want until you don't want it anymore. Even from the pulpit,
sure.
it's a manifest whatever your best life is ever, and God is going to give me everything I want. So how do you get past that mentality?
Sure. Great question. So I think one of my good friends calls Facebook fake book.
Okay.
And I think that we live in a society now where people are so tied to social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, and they see the representation that people put online about their lives, which really aren't a reality. Let's face it, mm-hmm. all of us don't take trips to Jamaica every year. All of us don't get an opportunity to eat at, you know, the fine dining restaurants. Mm-hmm. And so I think that sometimes people suffer with unnecessary depression and anxiety because they feel like their life is not matching up to what they see on social media. But I also would challenge anyone who thinks that life is going to be easy and simple it's a part of life, and I think that we have to help people accept that. Let's face it, we live in a DoorDash, Uber Eats, you know, drive-through kind of world. People want instantaneous turnarounds. No one wants to go through the process. But I want to encourage someone, just hang in there. Mm-hmm. I promise you, if you trust God, if you continue to press forward, mm-hmm. things will turn around, things will get better. And I think this is important, especially as we see the heightened rates of suicide, mm-hmm. Where, let's face it, I mean, life gets difficult for us all. Mm-hmm. And but I do believe that if we hang in there long enough, mm-hmm. things can turn around for us. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, it's important, especially like I said, with the whole hype around, you know, your best life ever,
yes.
positive vibes only. I don't want to hear it if it's a warning. I don't want to hear it if it's correction. And that will bring destruction.
It will.
Suddenly, instantly. And we need an intervention, and we need to know
right.
the gospel is good enough.
That's
you know,
right.
I think that we have gotten so tied into the world as the church.
Yes.
And even, you know, some of the things that we preach and project that we are so hungry.
Yes.
As pastors and preachers, teachers, ministers, evangelists, to feed people in a way in which we want them addicted
right.
to us.
Yes.
That oftentimes we leave out the gospel.
Well, you obviously saw my facial expression. My whole body lit up. Because I think that that's something that is not said enough. Mm-hmm. And the reality, I think that the pandemic really exposed that, because this cotton candy, pie in the sky, call it and haul it, grab it, blab it and grab it type gospel. When life hit people square between the eyes, they didn't have anything substantive and content-wise to hold on. And I think that people now are in search for truth, mm-hmm. unlike ever before. They're in search of authenticity. And they're like, listen, leave off the sprinkles, leave off the icing, give it to me raw, uncut, so that I can actually be able to be equipped to handle what life will bring my way.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And I like what you said about hang in there. You know, don't give up, don't give in, don't throw in the towel, because so many people want to give up. And I think the reason that they're giving up is because they don't have resilience.
Yes.
They're not taught to persevere. Like you said, they're Amazon, order today, get it today. And
that's
they
right.
think life works that way because social media does only depict, you know, just those really edited versions of life. And
yes.
And people eat there. That's their full meal for
that's
the day. They're not getting the word of God.
Right.
And they're not interested in the Word of God anymore.
Yes.
But it's still relevant.
It's still relevant. I love, obviously, I'm sure your viewers know that you are, I won't say an ex-athlete, you're still very much an athlete to this day. But I'm sure that you probably remember a time at the end of the season, perhaps there was a banquet or a gathering, trophies were given out, most improved or player or MVP. And, you know, maybe two or three people walked home with trophies. But now in today's world, you know, with kids, you just get a trophy for participating, right? And so I think that there's a lot of things that we do in our culture, society, that really don't prepare people for the tough days and the tough times. Mm-hmm. And I think this is really important for young people as well.
Mm-hmm.
I think that we have to be intentional to kind of go against the grain of what society is teaching. But you made a great point, as you mentioned, that a lot of people aren't looking for religion, they're not looking for tradition, but they need something that is fresh. And mm-hmm. so we know that the gospel transcends time, mm-hmm. but I do think that there are some creative ways that we can package it
mm-hmm.
so that people might be receptive and interested mm-hmm. into what the hope that Jesus brings.
Mm-hmm. Package it to don't look like yourself anymore, right?
Right. Well, I think there's a balance.
Because what's happening is it's being watered down.
It's being
and
watered
diluted
down. Yes.
To become palatable.
Yes.
And I've talked to a lot of young people. They don't like it.
Yes.
But they really appreciate it and respect it.
Right.
And I think that's across the board.
Yes.
Is that we too busy wanting the applaud, approval,
right.
and awards that we don't want to give people the gospel, because after I'm gone, my son's children's children, like
yes.
I do with my for my mother and grandmother, the gospel still is good enough to sustain me,
yes.
to pull me up out of a pig pen, to put me in the place that God wants me to be, to help me connect to my purpose, to give me the passion to continue on. And we don't give them a safety net.
Right.
We're too busy trying to entertain, and they have enough entertainers.
They do.
I don't know anybody to go to a dentist or a hospital to get entertained. You're coming there for a very serious thing, and I think that the young people are starting to know,
yes.
wait a minute, I'm still suffering in silence. I'm at your church, I'm all happy and feel good because it's passion, you know, packaged a certain way, but it's not taking away my pain.
Right.
Jesus Christ is still a painkiller, and he's still is himself.
Yes.
And we have to, if you want to do anything, take him out of Christianity and bring him into Christ.
Yes.
Because you have a variation of Christians that are being locked up for January 6th calling out the name of Jesus.
Yes.
They're Christians, right? So that becomes a religion. We need to get people back to Jesus Christ because he's the one that's not going to ever leave them or forsake them.
That's right.
He's the one that says, come unto me, all you that are laden and heavy laden, and I'll give you rest.
That's right.
Jesus has come, like you said, hey, I got you.
Right.
I'm going to weep with you.
That's right.
When we take that away and package it because we want to be popular, we want to get money, we want to do this and any other, that's watering down the gospel because it is good enough for me to give a young person.
Sure.
Jesus Christ himself,
sure.
as written in the gospel, it is good enough for me to give that, and that person will appreciate it 10 years later, 20 years later. But if I give them some fluff and stuff, oh, you can, God gonna forgive your sins. Just keep sinning. Who did Jesus say, just keep sinning?
Right, no, to nobody.
You sure?
Right.
And you
make,
sure?
And you make a great point.
He didn't tell people to keep sinning.
No, he didn't tell them to keep sinning.
Because they were like, well, you know, God know you a sinner, so just keep sinning and put it under grace.
Yeah, you're not gonna find it there. But and I love what you said. You know, I think especially with young people today, you know, reality TV has dominated, you know, their lives in terms of, but I always tell them, listen, you don't have to, if you pick up your Bible, trust me, there's enough drama, crises, trauma right there. And I think that as you look at, you know, whether it be, you know, Daniel in the lion's den or the three Hebrew boys in the fiery furnace, or, you know, you think about Noah in the middle of a flood, I think that those are great examples. And I could go on and on and on. Time won't permit us. But to say, listen, you're not the only person who's been in a rough situation, a tight situation. And to your point, I think that everything we need is right there in the gospel. All we have to do is present it to them to say, listen, you're not the first one to have lost a loved one. Let me give you some examples. And everything they need is right there. So,
Amen. Yes. Well, we're about out of time. Thank you again so much for
your
workout
and
the word that you gave us today.
Yes.
And I want to encourage you guys to get to know Jesus Christ yourself, because there's no other way to know him. Church is a great door and introduction, but I promise when you leave there, you'll have some personal issues and private storms to come into your life, that when you call on the name of Jesus, that he will respond and give you peace in the midst of that storm. I don't want to guarantee you that he's going to just come in and stop every storm, even though he can.
Right.
Sometimes it's ordained as you go through your lions, then you go through your fiery furnace, you go through your Red Sea. You got to go through so you can grow up,
you
can know who he is, and you can know that God is not just the God of give me more, that he's not just the God of give me money and manifest. That's some otherworldly stuff.
Yes.
God wants to show you that even at your worst, he's still a great God and greatly to be praised. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by him. He has come that we might have life and that more abundantly. It's the thief that comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Thank you so much for joining me with the pastor from the Favor Church, Pastor Reverend Barry. You guys have a great time, and we'll see you next time.